Welcome back. Welcome to stage 2 of the stake pool operator journey. In this stage, we are going to start the Jormungandr node. So in order to do that, we need to get the latest information for the testnet. You can do it on this website. The link is going to be in the show notes. And here you can see the different configurations for the different testnets. We have beta, nightly, and in your screen, you should also see incentivized testnet. So the version of nightly that is currently running is release candidate 9. This is the Genesis hash, and you can download the config YAML file from here. So we were going to download the version of Jormungandr that is appropriate for our testnet. In my case, I'm going to use nightly, but you should use the incentivized testnet. So let me write down the URL that you are going to need. You open that one, and it's a link to the GitHub's different releases. Since I'm using Linux, I'm going to download this version right here. If you are using Windows, this is the one you need. And if you are using Mac, one of the Linux versions or this might work. Okay, now let me download that file. You can download it obviously by clicking the link like this, right? And it starts to download. However, since I want to have it in the show notes, I'm doing it with curl from the command line. Once the file is downloaded, we need to extract it. On Linux, you do that with the tar command and the parameter -xsvf and the name of the file that you just downloaded. On Windows, you obviously will use your file navigator, and on Mac, you will use Finder. So it extracted the JCLI and the Jormungandr commands. Let's see which version of JCLI I got. I got JCLI-B and I got release candidate 9. Okay, now the next step is to get the configuration information. So we go back to the same website we were before. With the configuration options, and we will download the config YAML file here. Just click on it, click save, and you will get it. In my case, I'll write it by hand just that it's in the part of the show notes. And the next thing is we need to correct the config for a stake pool, because by default, this configuration is for a static node, and we want to set up an active node, which is, you know, a stake pool. So let me show you how those corrections look like. This is the file with our corrections. So we need to add the storage parameter and the listen address and the public IP on our file. For comparison, originally the file looked like this. We didn't have the storage parameter and we didn't have the topics of interest, all right? So we need to correct it to be like this, with a listen address, which is a connections we accept from the outside world, from other stake pools, the public address, how the other stake pools can find us, topics of interest, blocks and messages high. Originally they were normal and low, you can see here. Also to note is this parameter here, the listened address, which is the one we're going to use for JCLI. Okay, so how do I know my public address? The way to do it is on a website like maybe canyousee.me.org. On a website like that, the IP that appears is the IP that your computer is showing to the public. And then we can also check if our port is open. In our case, we need to check for port 3000 to see if it's available for the other stake pool operators. And currently it's closed. That's okay, we will get back to it later. Okay, now that I have the config YAML file, the stake pool config YAML file, I'll need to go back to the same website and save the genesis hash in a text file. So I'm going to create that here in the text file called genesis-hash.txt. And let me show you what my genesis hash has. It has this hash right here, 65A, and you see it's the same as here. So now I got the genesis hash and the stakepool config YAML file. Let's look at the files that I got. I have the Jormungandr JSLI executables, the file that I downloaded, the nightly config YAML file, which was the one that I got clicking here, the corrected one, which I called stakepool-config.yaml, and the genesis hash file that we just created to store this string. Okay, with that information, let me open a new terminal because I'm going to need it later. And now let's start the Jormungandr node with the, you know, Jormungandr executable. The parameter genesis block hash should be, of course, the genesis hash text file that we set up here. And the configuration is going to be the stakepool config YAML file that we corrected. We do that, and the node is starting. Okay, now we go to, after a couple of minutes, we go to the canyousee.me.org website, and let's see if we can check the port 3000, which is the one that we said that was open. And you see, now it says success. This can take a couple of minutes, but yeah, you should see success at some point. If not, means that your port is closed and you need to open it through your router and your computer's firewall. And let's check if the node is syncing. So we do JCLI rest node stats get and the name of the host, which this was in the REST API in the in stakepool config YAML file. We do that, and you can see here we have received 31 blocks. We are in the epoch 11 slot 5324. The latest block hash has been this, and this is the Jormungandr version that is running right here on the right. Okay, let me set up that a little bit below. Okay, perfect. Okay, and with that, we have finished stage 2 of the stateful operator journey. We are here.